Earnings reports now from some stock market heavyweights. SM Investments Corporation sees a 25% jump in full-year net income. It climbed to 77 billion pesos in 2023 from 61.7 billion the year before that. Consolidated revenues also up to over 616 billion pesos, higher by 11% year on year. The C family's banking business was the main driver of profit, chipping in 47%, followed by property, retail, and portfolio investments. Over now to real estate, where Mega World of Andrew Tan hit a record 19 billion peso net income last year. This was up by 26%, with net income attributable to the parents' shareholders at 17 billion. Consolidated revenues also jumped to near 70 billion pesos. Next to Philinvest Land, net income attributable to equity holders of the parent was up 30%, or from 2.89 billion pesos in 2022 to 3.77 billion pesos last year. Consolidated revenues and other income, meanwhile, climbed to 22.55 billion pesos. Finally, the Consunyi's mining firm Semirara caps the year in the red. Consolidated net income dropped by 30% to near 28 billion pesos from the 40 billion in 2022. Still, Semirara says coal investments and shipments, as well as electricity sales, helped cushion the blow of subdued coal and power prices. The Philippine Reclamation Authority bears some of its priority projects for the year. Our correspondent Andrea Taguines joins us on the line for that story and more. Hi, Andy. Go ahead.
Good afternoon, Sandy. The Philippine Reclamation Authority said it is expecting the resumption of two more reclamation projects along Manila Bay within this quarter or the next, according to PRA Assistant General Manager, Attorney Joseph Literal. These are the 90-hectare reclamation project in Bacoor, Cavite, and the nearly 16-hectare reclamation project by the Philippine Fisheries Development Authority in Navota City, which seeks to expand the city's fish port for the purpose of boosting food security. Literal said during their last meeting with the Department of Environment and Natural Resources, the PRA was told that the compliance report of these projects will be coming out soon. If you would recall, Sandy, back in August last year, President Ferdinand Marcos Jr. had ordered the suspension of all reclamation projects along Manila Bay while the Environment Department, the DENR, conducted a review of their environmental compliance and cumulative impact. That's after some environmental groups warned about the damage that these projects would cause to marine habitats as well as to coastal communities. Out of the 16 that were suspended so far, only two have been allowed to continue, namely the 265-hectare Pasay Harbor Reclamation Project and the SM Prime Reclamation Project, also in Pasay City, with the DENR noting that they were found to be fully aligned with the agency's guidelines. Meanwhile, Literal also addressed the claim of a fisher folk group that, despite the suspension order, dredging activities continue in Bacoor, Cavite.
Yung dredging activity sa Cavite, nahati yun sa dalawa eh. One is for PRA reclamation projects and the other one is for the Bulacan Airport. So hindi covered ng suspension yung sa Bulacan Airport because they're not classified as reclamation projects within Manila Bay. The ECC itself stated that it's a land development project. Yun po yung nagko-continue. Rest assured po na pagdating po sa reclamation projects that were approved by PRA, we have been monitoring them since the first day of the suspension. And right now, ang tumatakbo lang talaga are the two Pasay reclamation projects.
Aside from the one in Bacoor and in the Navota Fish Port, Literal is hoping two more reclamation projects will be given the green light this year. That's the Manila Solar City and the 650-hectare Navota Reclamation Project, the biggest one in the list, which Literal said can serve as a support facility for the Bulacan Airport that's currently being built. Literal also said that these projects will bring in lots of revenues for the government and would raise further the PRA's total unaudited asset value, which is already at 150 billion pesos. He also assured the public that they are working with project proponents, the LGUs involved, and the National Anti-Poverty Commission to provide assistance to fisher folks and other sectors that will be directly or indirectly affected by such reclamation activities. Sandy?
All right. Thank you so much for the update, Andy.